I want to shift now to the People's Law Enforcement Board. It's a little known avenue to seek justice. What made you think of filing the case in partnership with the People's Law Enforcement Board? Tell us more about that, and what can this board do?
Whatever decision that this cyclist may have made at the end, meaning to enter into some sort of, quote, compromise or settlement, close quote, would not have happened if the police officers who had handled this case from the outset had done their job. There is a manual of the PNP with regard to first responders who are made aware of the commission of crimes. They should have done what was required of them under their own rules of operation. The ones who entertained the parties and who even received their respective written statements at the Kamuning police station, they also had an opportunity to do what was right, and they didn't. Instead, they forwarded this matter to the Galas police station. The delay, coupled with the cyclist's probable fright, being in the presence of so many police officers, the hunger that he'd experienced, and the long hours that he was made for the police to do something, all of this can clearly be considered as to why he finally relented, succumbed to the pressure, and came out with that agreement, which is definitely quite one-sided against him. He was even made to pay 500 pesos, despite the fact that, as we saw in the video, he was hit on the head very fiercely, a gun was pointed at him, and it was cocked, and his right shoulder was punched, his bicycle dragged to the curb. All of these injustices really revolted all those who had seen it. And there must be some resolution that is adequate and in accordance with law.
I don't know if you've seen the aggressor gave an interview. And what he claims there is that he was the one who was actually under threat.
Well, that probably is in his mind only. I think we all saw what the threat was. It all came from him. The cyclist himself was not even with any gloves, yet he says that the cyclist had gloves with knuckles. He says that the cyclist had a screwdriver, but we all saw as well that the cyclist was actually for fear of his life from the moment that gun was pulled from the assailant's waist.
So now we're talking about the traffic altercation. We're also talking about, you know, the systems that should have been in place and the actions that should have been done by police officers. But when you talk about the People's Law Enforcement Board, what other issues can this board actually solve or help bring justice to? Because it's a little known avenue, as I said a while ago, to attain justice. Go ahead.
Very few cities actually have this People's Law Enforcement Board. It's a good thing that the place where this incident happened, Quezon City, has a People's Law Enforcement Board. Not only does this board have the power to discipline police officers who violate their own operations manuals, it can actually be a good reason or an example that other cities may want to implement, so that its citizenry may feel more safe in the face of police violence.
All right. And tell us about how this all works now. After you filed the case and now and with this board, what's the expectation here and how will this all play out?
Yes, that's why beginning tomorrow, there's going to be a Senate hearing. And me as a lawyer, I really wish that the Senate would and the Congress would do its part for the enactment of either new laws in order to protect cyclists, probably amend our own laws on the greater restrictions or requirements in order for a person to acquire handguns, probably an improvement on the benefits to companies who would encourage their employees to use their bicycles and going to work, coming from work, probably a change or a reduction in the taxes to be imposed on bicycle parts, so that again it will encourage people to use bicycles. This is an opportunity really for our lawmakers to enact laws which would help to decongest traffic in our metropolis and in other cities.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Attorney Raymond Fortun there, moderator for Pinoy Road Bikers. Thank you so much, Archie, for joining us today. Take care and keep safe.
Thank you, Carmina, and I'll do that. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you.